Hello students, I am Mr. Rohan Sogle, and today again we are here to continue with the lecture of vacuum cleaner. As in previous lecture, we have studied the points related to the vacuum cleaner, that is, we have studied the history of vacuum cleaner, then we have studied what are the six essential components of this vacuum cleaner, then we have studied the friction concept. Because of this friction concept, how these air particles move in the vacuum cleaner along with the air. Then again we have studied the brush, how this rotating brush used, or why this rotating brush used in this vacuum cleaner. Then we have also studied the vacuum cleaner bag, okay, which also act as a filter, which removes the dust particle from the air, and it should how or where it should be placed. So basically this vacuum cleaner bag or dust bag is placed in between the intake pipe and exhaust port. Again we have studied the different types of this vacuum cleaner. In first type, this dust bag or vacuum cleaner bag is placed at the end of this and in the another example we have seen that this airbag, so not airbag, this dust bag is placed before the fan. So as per the design, we can place the bag or dust bag before at the starting of this vacuum cleaner, or we can place at the end of this vacuum cleaner, but the precaution should be take care that or precaution we have to take care sorry the precaution we have to take that whatever bag is there, that bag should be placed in between the intake port and exhaust port. Okay, so now in this video lecture we are going to study the what are the different factors which affects the suction. So the power of vacuum cleaner, so the power of vacuum cleaner suction depends on the number of factors. The suction will be strong or weaker, these are depends on the following factors. So one of the first factor is the power of the fan. We know that we have already studied that vacuum cleaner has fan, and this fan is connected to the electric motor. So as the motor turns, the fan also start rotating. So we know that the whatever electric motor is there, that electric motor rotates at a constant speed. So if the rotation speed or whatever motor has is there, if that motor has to turn at a good speed, or if the motor turns at a good speed, it will generate a strong suction. If the motor rotates at a low speed, then it will create a weaker suction. So remember that for a good suction or for a strong suction, the motor has to turn at a good speed. So this is one of the first factor on which the suction is depend. Now next we are having the blockage of the air passage away. So here I have written that when a great deal of debris when a great deal of debris is built up in a vacuum bag, the air faces greater resistance on its way out. So we know the debris, so these are small particles of the maybe of paper, maybe of cloth, so small particles are there. So if when we deal with the debris, okay, which are there in the vacuum bag. So suppose number of particles, or we can consider number of dust particles in the airbag are more. So we know that this airbag act as a filter. So whatever air come inside this vacuum cleaner, it passed through this airbag. So whatever dust particles are there, that dust particles are get collected in that bag, and whatever fresh air is there, that fresh air is passes out or pass out from this bag. So if the number of dust particles are more, then that dust particle automatically, as this bag act as a filter, they automatically get stuck to that airbag. So if the number of debris or number of dust particles are more, then it creates a greater resistance while it passes out. So again, this also matters. So as the number of particles are more, dust particles or debris are more, so due to that, whatever air is there, that air moves more slowly because of the increased drags. So if less dust particles are there, that means more holes are available for the air to pass out. But if the dust particles are more, so they automatically will get stuck on that wall of this bag. So they produce the resistance to this air. So due to that, suction process is also decreases. So again, another part we are having is that the size of opening at the end of the intake port. Okay, so again, the size of opening is also matters, since the speed of vacuum fan is constant. Okay, that we know that whatever fan is there, that rotate at a constant speed. The amount of air passing through the vacuum cleaner per unit time is also constant. Obviously, if whatever fan is there, if the fan is rotating at a constant speed, it means that obviously whatever air is there, whatever air passes through the vacuum cleaner, it passes at a constant time. So for this, no matter what size you make the intake port, so size of intake port does not matter. So as fan rotate at a constant speed, constant amount of vacuum is passed through the vacuum cleaner. So it doesn't matter what size or what is the size of intake port. No matter what size you make the intake port, the same amount of air particle will have to pass into the vacuum cleaner every second. Okay, so we know that. So if you make the ports smaller, suppose you have make the ports smaller, but the fan speed is constant, okay, and you have make the ports smaller, then in that case, the individual air particle will have to move much more quickly in order for them all to get through in that amount of time. So as I said, as fan rotate in a constant speed. But in this case, what you have done, you have made the port smaller. So speed of motor is constant, but you have made, so whatever, sorry, speed of motor is constant, so same amount of air should be taken inside the vacuum cleaner, but in that case you have made the port smaller, so space is less, but we have to take same amount of air inside the vacuum cleaner. So due to that, what happens, the whatever speed is there, that suction speed is increases. Okay, so at this point where the air speed is increases and pressure inside this vacuum cleaner decreases. So when this happens, when we make port smaller, okay, so when we make port smaller, in that case air speed increases and pressure decreases. So the drop in pressure translates the greater suction force at the intake port. So due to the pressure drop, suction is increases, it gives the greater suction force. Okay, because they create a stronger suction force, narrower vacuum attachment can pick up heavier dirt particles than wider attachment. So if you place narrower suction attachment, so due to that narrow suction attachment, as we have discussed, the air speed increases, it provides the greater suction force. So whatever heavier dirt particles are there, heavier dust particles are also get collected inside that vacuum cleaner. Okay, but if you are having the wider attachment, then it is not possible in this case. So these are the some factors which affects the suction. So first factor we have studied, that is power of the fan. Then we have studied the blockage of air passageway, and then we have studied the size of opening at the end of intake port. So on this point or on these factors, our suction is depend. So now let's discuss this type of vacuum cleaner, that is central vacuum system. What is this central vacuum system? So as we know that in the first lecture we have studied this. So whatever first vacuum cleaner dating from mid of 1800, so in the mid of 1800, whatever vacuum cleaners were there, the vacuum cleaner used hand operated bellows to create the suction. So this we have discussed, the bellows were used for the suction mechanism. Okay, these came in all shapes and size and were of minimal help in daily cleaning. Okay, the first electric vacuum cleaner showed up in the early 90s were an immediate success. So we got this electrical vacuum cleaner in the early 90s and it had a very good success in the market. So one very popular vacuum cleaner design is a central vacuum system which turns whole house into cleaner. So this history we have already studied, that first vacuum cleaner was developed in mid 18th. In the 18th century, we say that in the 18th century or in the mid of 18th century, first vacuum cleaner was developed, and in the 19th century, the electrical vacuum cleaners were developed, and then nowadays we are having different types of vacuum cleaner available in the market, but the one of the very popular vacuum cleaner design is the central vacuum system. So what is this central vacuum system? Here I have tried to show one diagram of this center, how this central vacuum system is there. So to use the cleaner, we have to turn on the fan motor and attach a hose to any of the various pipe outlet throughout the house. So this is a hose. Okay, so in the left diagram, I have shown the two diagrams. In the left diagram, we see the hose. Okay, and what we have to do, we have to attach this hose to any of various pipe outlets. So this is a pipe outlet, so which is there on the wall. So just what we have to do in case of central vacuum system, we have to attach this pipe, we have to attach this hose to the pipe outlet. Okay, this pipe outlet is throughout the house. Okay, in every room we'll get this type of pipe outlets. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to just turn on the fan motor and we have to attach this hose to this pipe outlet. So here in the second diagram, so different pipe outlets are there. So this is a, okay, just look at this point number two. So here you will get one of the pipe. So this is one of the pipe outlet. So this directly, this is in the top floor of the building. So from this it is connected to this canister. Okay, so this is a canister, okay, which is used to collect the dust. So to this canister different pipe outlets are connected. So from each floor we are having the pipe outlets and these are connected to this canister. We can place this canister in the ground floor, or we can also place this canister outside the house also. So this, all the pipe outlets are connected to this canister. Okay, and these pipe outlets, if you see, these are pipe outlets are there throughout the house. Okay, so in this floor we are also having, here we are also having the pipe outlet. So this again connected to this canister. Again here also we are having the fourth point, this is also we are having the pipe outlet, which is again connected to canister. So in the central vacuum system, throughout the building, we are having these pipe outlets, and these pipe outlets are connected to this canister. So just what we have to do, simply we have to connect, or we have to simply turn on the fan, and we have to just connect, or we have to just attach the hose to any one of these pipe outlet. So once the cleaning process start, whatever fan is there, that dust particles are sucked by this fan system or this intake system, and this sucked dust particle are placed or placed into the pipe and are deposited in the large canister, which we have to empty only a few times in a year. Okay, so this is a simple thing is there, else remaining part is same. So here I have shown one system where here intake port is there. It consists of fan and brush. It just collect the dust, and through this hose, and this pipe outlet, whatever dust is there, that dust is transferred towards this canister. Okay, so these canisters are large enough so that we have to empty them a few times in a year, or we can say once in a month also we can clean this canister. So due to this system, the cleaning of house is become very easy. So this is a simple central vacuum system. So I hope you understand the central vacuum system. So in this lecture, we have studied the vacuum cleaner. We have studied the different factors on which this vacuum cleaner suction is depend. We have studied the first factor. We have studied that is fan. There is power of fan. Then we have studied the blockage of air passage away. Then we have studied the size of opening at the end of the intake port. So on these three, the suction is depend. Then after that, we have studied this central vacuum system. So in the central vacuum system, we have various pipe outlets. And just what we have to do, we have to connect the hose to this pipe outlet, and when we turn on the fan motor, the whatever dust particles are there, that dust particles are sucked into the pipes and are deposited into the large canister, and this large canister we have to empty only few times in a year. Okay. So this is about this central vacuum system and the factors on which the suction is depend. So we'll stop over here, and in the next lecture we'll discuss the next point related to the vacuum cleaner. Okay, thank you.